Hey guys, little preface before we start. So for those of you who might have noticed, there's a little bit of a drastic level change between parts 5 and 6, how I've sort of moved on to near the end of the the Castle Stronghold. This is because, unfortunately, when I was recording the original episodes 6 and 7, I had botched the audio and thus lost the footage. I couldn't really cover much. So, as I wanted to keep progressing through the game, there's going to be an extra episode at the end of the series featuring a different character and two of the important levels that were dropped. Enjoy the video. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Gauntlet Dark Legacy. As always, I'm your host, Greenleaf, and in today's episode, we continue with the Sky Dominion. Move on to levels 2 and 3.
You are now entering Cloud Docks.
Yes, the Cloud Docks. I rather actually like the Cloud Docks. But these things I hate. Not gonna lie, I have no freaking clue what they're actually supposed to be. Ugly is one thing. Yeah, we're in the sky now. Oh, yeah. The one thing about these levels is bombs. And also, since they're in the sky and there's planes and stuff, the planes can and will run you over. Ow! Even when I'm nowhere near them. I got on and off of it before it took off. That's gotta be a new record.
Acid amulet.
Oh yeah. I haven't gotten the acid amulet yet. Sometimes I just like to look at the skybox and see what's different about it. And to give the illusion that everything is floating, it seems like actually the skybox itself is actually just moving. Touché, Midway, touché. Back wheel. That one was junk. I forgot about that. Friends are further and you cannot return. Oh well. Momentary setback. Reflective shield. The interesting thing to note about this realm is that this is the first realm where we can go from levels 1 to boss. Thanks to, not thanks to death, but rather thanks to the fact that we got the Javelin of Blinding back in the mountain. Oh, I might ask, well, what blinds the Javelin of, well, what gets blinded by the Javelin of Blinding? Well, stick with us, I'll show you.
Better.
that's more what the true purpose of the turbo is for. Is if you get just stuck in sort of a loop of fighting things. But at least then you've got a combat out there right for you. Oh, by the way, the generals really don't care about you until you actually attack. So sometimes if you get close enough, start here. Better disrupt. Better, 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 better disrupt. Better, better, disrupt. Better disrupt. Mail can distract you from a higher goal.
Oh.
Green Jester has gained a level.
Feel the burn. Why is he Alrighty, let's get back. We'll deal with those guys. After we come back, they'll probably spawn more, which means more experience for us. Aha! But it said, don't let a meal just distract you from a hard goal. What could that mean? Perhaps it means a rune stone! I knew it! That's rune power stones. Better, 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 bring death on. I can take him. He's somewhere. They usually don't give you this thing without death being nearby. Usually. Perhaps he spawned in the second game. Or the two-player game. But I'll see if I can find him anyway. One thing here is to always fire forward. Why? Or wait, no, it wasn't this one. It's a different one. There's another level that has you going up a path. Oh, right. Here he is. I have stolen from the jaws of death himself. Gargoyles you're finding, as for those of you who can't tell, your heavy attack does push them back. The problem is that if you push them too far back, when they die and drop their golden icon, it can fall off the level and it will not pop back up if it does. So in essentiality, you have to fight it again and redo the level, or pray that you actually get enough coming levels. Go to the exit portal.
Green Jester has gained a level.
I guess it would have been better to buy the meat. Oh well. Alrighty. And oh. Right, I grabbed.
Congratulations! You have found a runestone!
And On to the next level we go.
Sky Shipyard.
Ah, yes. This is where we get the good book. Go get it, and that'll wrap up this video. But in the next one, tell you what, go finish this realm, beat the snot out of the boss of this level. But and then after we fight him, we'll go and we'll fight the boss of Forsaken Province. Oh, waste. Oh, whatever. There's three things in here. Better. This is the level. There we go. Yes. I forgot this also introduced the shrinker. That just basically makes enemies a lot easier to kill. And it makes generals hilarious to fight because they're a little less sized. And also it makes killing them easier too. And of course it makes the incubators very small. I keep thinking there's always something that... No, I remember when I do free player with this, death uses sponsor one of those. I don't know why that one's destructible considering there's nothing up there, but... ...neat little things that they accidentally left in the game. Fire breath and electric amulet. And off this roll. So I always thought this was a cool little transition. Mighty brave for fighting things shirtless. No shirt, no top. There's the good book. This one was a little bit tricky for me at first, because I think there was a second step. Let's first reach the exit to obtain the book of protection. That's where the general was. I remember there was one near. Thank you.